I'm Parker McKay. I'm 29 years old and I live in Nashville, Tennessee. My whole life has centered around music, musical theater, honor choir. Anytime I could get my hands on a microphone, I bet it was in my hand. I was an only child and my mom and I were fiercely close. She was like, we were always in the car just listening to music. My mom drove me to my first ever audition when I was 17 years old and was just a beacon of encouragement and love. At 23, I moved to Nashville, and I thought, everyone's trying to come here, I should do that too, and over time, I just realized that that wasn't really where I wanted to go, but I learned so much from country songwriting, and was able to parlay that into pop songwriting. I was growing, doing videos, and putting music out, which was the coolest thing ever. But then, 5 years ago, my mom started acting drastically different. And just becoming not my mom. And we didn't really understand what was going on. She had what's called frontotemporal dementia. And it affects your behavioral skills, short-term memory. Her fire was just dwindling. And we didn't know why for a really long time, which is really hard. We just want to help her get better, and we tried so many things over years. And it was no longer possible to really have a conversation with her. She wasn't really present, except for when I would sing to her. Her eyebrows would lift, and I sat her down and said, "Mom, I have some news for you. I'm going to do a voice." And she went, "Are you excited?
Yeah. Did it say who the mentors were? Just in case, right? Yeah, you do.
As Angelinos, we're all ready to get back to the things we love, and for them to care helps ensure them enjoyment for years to come. Because we have kids to raise, championships to win, people to inspire, dogs to walk, plants to swim, pictures to paint.
Hey.
One of my tiny cooks in the fridge. I woke with the babies lying on my blanket and I can't get up otherwise. Hi, Mika.
Haley, if you decide you want, you can use my fan.
Thank you.
Just pull it and turn it towards you.
Wait, so where exactly are you going to sleep?
Uh-huh.
I'm going to sleep right here?
Well, I figured that's what you wanted.
Yeah, but I was wondering what mattress.
On the floor?
This is why we need an air mattress.
No. I have suggested the cursor on the floor.
No.
I need an air mattress.
No, you don't.
Who is that? That's the
What's his face's wife?
He can't take control of his care.
I know. And we will once we know what we're dealing with.
The Pneumothorax was easily resolved, and Nick hasn't done anything purposeful since the Paramedics found her.
Which could mean a myriad of things. Accidental ingestion, electrolyte abnormality.
Sure. It's a possibility. Made from the neck down, Nick appears to be okay.
But the impact from the crash may have damaged her brain. Badly. Let's not catastrophize just yet. Where's Megan? Oh, Dr. Progress, you're not looking too good.
She's right, kind of slow down when you're still recovering.
I'm fine. Hey, where's Megan? She's in CT. Come rest with her. Kids keep her posted. Whoa, buddy, hold on. Hey, didn't I just discharge? It's Nick. I'm not going home. Okay, but you're also not going to bed yet. Let's find a place to lie down. What are you doing? It's fine.
It's subtle, but there's some evidence of edema.
We're used to looking at scans of older people. The young brain is bound to look for a contrast.
Well, these tiny particular hemorrhages in the base of the ganglia tell us there's damage. The only question is how will it evolve?
Since he had COVID.
That's a lot of wheezing I'm hearing. How do you feel about checking in with all the dental chest day?
I told you they have met me.
Hey, Dr. Austin. Let's get Mr. Sandoval started on a med. Order a chest x-ray and give him 125 IV solumedrol.
Is Nurse Neff in here? She always likes to know how Gabe is doing.
Not tonight. Sit tight. I'll get you fixed up, Mr. Sandoval, okay?
He's not angry with you. He's terrified. Which is exactly how I felt when he didn't know what happened to you.
That comrade was with you the whole time I was unconscious. I need to be there for him.
Just give him time.
If Nick doesn't turn a corner soon, there may not be much time.
Thank you.
She's having trouble with alcohol.
So her EKG and her echo were normal. There's no evidence of any arrhythmia that could have preceded this.
Swelling on the CT wasn't an overcall. Her intracranial pressure is high.
Did we start her on Nitrosyn?
We start her on hypertonic saline, Lasix, and mannitol. If that doesn't work,
it has to work.
Don't mind me,
dear.
There's nowhere else I need to be.
No, Sherry's an old pro. She sat beside Gabe for the 6 months he was in ICU recovering from COVID.
6 months, 1 week, 5 days. Is bronchoscopy 2 or 3?
That's 3.
I like to write everything down. I know you keep Gabe's records in the clouds. You don't have them, but I like to keep my own account right here.
Hey, baby. Park this coat right there. CO's trachea collapses every time it breathes. That's what's causing the wheezing. It's the tracheomalacia. Again. Here, baby, I'll do it.
He needed all that time on the breathing tube for COVID, but it made his trachea weaker for him.
And given his history, I'm afraid we're going to have to go back to the tracheostomy tube.
Oh, you hated that so much. How long will he need it?
That is most likely going to need to tend to later as well. And the damage to his trachea is so extensive, it's the only way we can get Gabe to breathe safely. Sure, I know this is not what any of us want, but I promise you it is the best that we have.
No explanation from police on what caused the accident.
Not yet, no.
I texted my peer group to include Nick. I hope that's okay.
How's she doing? Listen about earlier issue. What's this?
Can I include a picture of my sweater? What are results you had the dogs?
Two huskies. I remember. Carpet hit by a snow block.
Worst TBI we see, but she recovered. So I can figure out why she did it so I can help Nick make it through.
Elaine Quinn's scans were entirely different than Nick's. She had a brain bleed. We were able to intervene on that. I know that's not what you want to hear.
it's time to put her in a peanut butter cell coma.
Get your word to her, Marie. This is your call. How do you approach this? You're the doctor. If we put her in a coma, she can't wake up until the sedatives wear off. How can I know she's improving if she's being flooded with sedatives?
We rely on monitoring parameters. Listen, I have to do something I don't want to do. I have to talk to you the way I would the spouse of any other patient. Unfortunately, despite our meds, the pressure in your wife's brain is still too high. If we don't put her in a medically induced coma, we risk compromising any chance she has of recovery.
Let's chuck his shit at me.
Pick it up, put it outside, stupid.
He freaking dead me so that's good.
It's behind you. It wasn't right there. Get the one on the ground? Matthew, where do you think the bottle I threw at you was?
It was right here.
Who put the dryer back on?
You did?
You did? Hey! You put the dryer back on?
No.
So what is it? It wasn't me.
You.
It wasn't me.
Not you, her.
I didn't change it.
Dude, it's fucking possessed. Because you went over there.
I opened it, checked it, and then started it again. I didn't change the time.
Oh, then no, I didn't change it.
It was Matthew.
It was Matthew.
It had to be you.
What was even over there?
Matt, shut the fuck up.
Thank you.